Hello friends, in this video we will be learning an important topic, that is 2:1 multiplexer as universal logic circuit. In fact, this is quite new for us because so far we were knowing that only NAND and NOR gate are universal logic gates, but in fact multiplexer can also be used as universal logic circuit. Let us study how. So particular logic gate or a particular logic circuit can be treated as universal logic gate or universal logic circuit if it is able to satisfy three laws, that is AND law, OR law and NOT law. So if we are able to implement NOT gate, AND gate, else OR gate with the help of a particular logic circuit, then that circuit can be named as universal logic circuit, because the circuit which is capable to give you product, the circuit which capable to give you sum also, and also it is able to give you complement, then by using these three basic operations we can actually have any Boolean expression or any circuit of combinational logic circuit, or in fact even a sequential logic circuit will also do. So let's start how to make use of 2:1 multiplexer as universal logic circuit. So first of all, I'll be using 2:1 multiplexer as NOT gate. So my requirement is NOT gate, which has only one input and one output. This is what the symbol of NOT gate is, and the relation between output and input is Y equal to A complement. Therefore, whenever A equal to 0, you must get Y value as 1, and for A equal to 1, you must get Y value as 0, which is complement of 0 and complement of 1. So what you can see over here is 2:1 multiplexer having two inputs I0, I1 and one output which is Y and one select line called as S0. The key point is, whenever you want to implement a particular logic gate, you have to give a name to select line as if it is input of a gate. So since we got only one input and only one select line, I'm going to name S0 as if it is A. So now ask yourself, when S0 equal to 0, where Y gets connected to? Of course, Y gets connected to 0 input. When S0 is equal to 1, where output gets connected to? It gets connected to 1. Now the question is, when S0 is equal to 0, it is possible only when A is equal to 0, because A and S0 are not different now. So when A is equal to 0, we know the fact Y gets connected to 0. But then in NOT gate, what output I want? What output I want is 1. Therefore, I'm going to have logic 1 here. Therefore, what will happen when A is equal to 0, Y gets connected to 0 input, and 0 input is applied with logic 1. So Y becomes equal to 1. Similarly, when A is equal to 1, S0 becomes 1. When S0 is equal to 1, Y gets connected to 1. Now the question is, when A is equal to 1, what output you want? So what output I want is 0, therefore the second input is now connected to 0, and now this is how it is going to behave as if it is a NOT gate. Let's cross check this. So when A is equal to 0, you know that Y is equal to I0, but as you can see I0 is connected to 1, so I can say Y equal to 1. Similarly, when the value of A is equal to 1, then we know the fact Y is always equal to I1, but what you can see, I1 is already connected to 0, so Y is equal to 0. So what is our concentration point should be? When A equal to 0, Y equal to 1, and when A equal to 1, Y is equal to 0. This is how it is behaving as if it is a NOT gate, even though internally it is 2 is to 1 multiplexer, right? Let's go on implementing 2 is to 1 multiplexer as OR gate as well as AND gate. So when I want OR gate, first of all, I'll have OR gate truth table, which is A and B inputs, and of course Y is output, and possible combinations of A and B are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. For every combination, some output you will get. For 0, 0 in OR gate, output is 0. For 0, 1, you get 1. For 1, 0, you get 1. And for 1, 1, you get 1. You know the nature of OR gate. For OR gate, when one of the input is equal to 1, output is 1. And of course, when both the inputs are also at 1, output is also 1. So this is the nature what I want. What I have done, I made exactly two partitions here. In upper part, as you can see, A equal to 0, and in lower part, A is equal to 1. In this case, now try to get Y in terms of B for every combination of A. That is, for first two cases, as you can see, A equal to 0. For rest of the two cases, A equal to 1. In both the cases, try to get Y in terms of B. So, as you can see, for A equal to 0, when B equal to 0, Y is 0. When B equal to 1, Y is 1. So, can I say that Y is exactly copy of B? So, I'll say Y equal to B. So, what needs to be remembered? When A equal to 0, Y should be equal to B. Similarly, when A is equal to 1, let's see. When B is equal to 0, Y is 1. And when B is equal to 1, Y is still 1. Meaning that Y is independent of B. Y is permanently 1. Since we know this nature of OR gate, let us try to implement with the help of 2 is to 1 multiplexer. So, I naught, I 1 is input, Y is output, S naught is a select line. Is that right? As we have already discussed in NOT gate, you have to treat A as input of select line. That is, input of select line as A. So, I'll make this as A. Right? Tell me. According to requirement, when A equal to 0, we know that it causes S naught to become 0. Therefore, output gets connected to I naught. Now, my question is, what output you want? Output should be equal to what? B. Therefore, I'll connect I naught to B. So, Y is equal to B. So, concentrate on this. When A equal to 0, Y is equal to B. And this is what the nature of OR gate is. But this is only half nature we have covered. Last combination also we should take into consideration. When the value of A is equal to 1, A equal to 1 causes S naught to become 1. S naught equal to 1 causes Y to get connected to I1. The question is, what output you want? So, as you can see, when A equal to 1, output should be equal to 1. So, I1 will be connected to logic 1. So, here, as you can see, I1 is connected to logic 1. So, what you should notice, when A equal to 1, Y is equal to 1. Is that right? This is how 2 is to 1 multiplexer can be used as OR gate also. In the next slide, we will see how to use 2 is to 1 multiplexer as AND gate. So, let's use 2 is to 1 multiplexer as AND gate. So, before we proceed, we must understand the truth table of AND gate first, because that is only help us to get multiplexer configuration to get converted as if it is behaving as AND gate. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1 is the combination. The nature of AND gate as if it is, when one of the input is connected to 0, output is 0. In fact, output is 1 only when both the inputs are 1. So, for only one combination, when A1, B1, you get Y1, and for rest of the combination, output is always 0. So, again, I'm following the same. For first two combination, A equal to 0. For rest of the two combinations, A is 1. For A equal to 0 and A equal to 1, similarly, as I did in OR gate, I'll try to get Y in terms of B. So, what you see here, when B is 0, Y is 0. When B is 1, Y is 0, means irrespective of B, Y is always 0. Similarly, in the last, when B is equal to 0, Y equal to 0. When B equal to 1, Y is equal to 1. So, can I say Y is exactly copy of B? So, Y is equal to B. So, my ultimate aim, when A equal to 0, I want my output to become 0. When A equal to 1, I want to copy the status of B on Y. And this is what is AND gate. This is 2:1 multiplexer that we have. S0 will be as usual input A. Now, the question is, when A is equal to 0, it causes S0 to become 0. S0 equal to 0 again causes output Y to become equal to I0. But the question is, what you want at output? So, as we have already noticed, when A equal to 0, we must get Y equal to 0. Therefore, I0 will be connected to logic 0. Is that right? Next, when A is equal to 1, it causes S0 to become 1. S0 equal to 1 causes Y to get connected to I1. But again, the question is, when A equal to 1, what output you want to see? When A equal to 1, as you can see, you want to see output, it is B. So, I1 should be connected to B. So, I1, as you can see, it is connected to B. So, this is how it is satisfying. When A equal to 0, output is 0. When A equal to 1, as you can see, Y is straight away B. And if it happens, then it behaves as if it is AND gate. So, we have understood how to use 2:1 multiplexer as NOT gate, AND gate, as well as OR gate, right? So, with these three examples, it is crystal clear that 2:1 multiplexer can be used as universal logic circuit. We shall see one more circuit or one more gate. So, let us use 2:1 multiplexer as NAND gate, and again, I'll be using the similar method. So, first of all, I'll start with the truth table of NAND gate, which will have two inputs A and B, and output is Y. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1 are the four possible combinations, and NAND gate is exactly inverse version of AND gate. When one of the input is 0, AND gate we get 0, but in NAND gate we will get 1. I repeat, when one of the input is connected to 0, output is always 1 for NAND gate. So, as you can see, one of the input is 0, output is continuously 1. Output is 0 only when both the inputs are 1. So, even in this, I will make partition. In first two combinations, as you can see, A is commonly 0. And for last two combinations, as you can see, A is commonly 1. And as usual, we are going to get Y in terms of B for every combination of A. So, for A equal to 0, as you can see, when B is 0, Y is 1, B is 1, Y is 1, meaning that Y is independent of B and Y is always equal to 1. Similarly, for A equal to 1, let us see, when B is 0, Y is 1, when B is 1, Y is 0, don't you see, Y is complemented version of B. So, I suppose to say, Y is equal to what? B bar. Is that right? So, let's try implementing. So, as usual, this is I0, I1, this is S0, and this is output Y. Again, I'll be connecting S0 to A. The question is, when A equal to 0, Y gets connected to I0, and what output you want is 1. Therefore, I'll be connecting I0 to 1. Similarly, when A is equal to 1, output should be equal to B complement, meaning that I1 must be connected to B bar. But we know that every variable or every literal is available in uncomplemented form. To get complemented form, you don't have it directly available. So you have to really generate B bar. And how do you generate B bar? It's very simple. Again, you'll have to use one more 2:1 multiplexer as NOT gate. So when you want NOT gate, when B is equal to 0, you want output 1. When B equal to 1, output should be 0. So output of this can be treated as B bar, and B bar you can connect over here. Is that right? So what I have used this 2:1 multiplexer as NOT gate, and the whole combination with respect to A and B, it will act as NAND gate. So I'm sure now you can implement even any other gate. So you just try and implementing NOR gate, XOR gate, XNOR gate using 2:1 multiplexer. Thank you.